Also today, Republican Congresswoman Marjorie Taylor Greene once again defending her controversial rhetoric one day after her colleagues voted to remove her from her committee assignments.
Going forward, I've been freed. I do. I feel freed because you know what's happening on these committees? You see, we have basically a tyrannically controlled government right now. The Democrats.
How does her party move forward now that Trump's out of office? Her response? It doesn't.
I want to tell you, Republican voters support him still. The party is his. It doesn't belong to anybody else.
Let's start there with our CNN congressional correspondent, Jessica Dean, who had quite an exchange with her earlier today at the press conference, and we'll get to that in just a sec. You know, she apologized a little, but also attacked a lot. Jessica.
Yeah, Brooke, good afternoon to you. When we were outside with the Congresswoman earlier today, she did go through some prepared remarks first, and she talked about how she supports the First Amendment and freedom of press, and how she wants to like us, the press, being us there in that comment. But then when it got to the question and answer portion, I pressed her on some specifics, because while we saw her both today and also yesterday say that looking back, she shouldn't have said the things she said. Today she said she was sorry for the things she said, but she wouldn't talk specifics. Here's our exchange.
I just wanted to ask you specifically, I know you talked yesterday, I listened to your speech, but you said on a video in January of 2019, I'm just going to read it to you verbatim. You said it's been taken out of
context. Who are you with? What's your name?
I'm Jessica Dean. With CNN. By our law, representatives and senators can be kicked out and no longer serve in our government. And it's a crime punishable by death is what treason is. This is what you said.
Did you see my speech yesterday? How many stories did you report on Russian collusion conspiracy lies? No, I want to know, have you apologized for Russian collusion conspiracy lies? Have you? I don't have to.
Stand by the fact that you said Nancy Pelosi is guilty of treason, and that's.
I think you heard my speech yesterday. You owe the people an apology. You lied about President Trump. You owe the people an apology. I've done mine yesterday.
So again, simply just not responding to those specific questions. That specific statement is one that we saw House Democrats really zeroing in on, of course, the threats of violence around House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, and she simply would not answer that specific question if she still stood by those comments today. Again, she did say she was sorry for the things she had said, but wouldn't get into specifics, wouldn't apologize for specific things or say exactly if she still believed so many of the lies and conspiracy theories that she had talked about previously. So, Brooke, from here, we know she's been stripped from her committees. She says that's just going to give her more free time to help former President Donald Trump with whatever his next venture is and to help other conservative Republican candidates in 2022. And she says, as you heard her in that clip just a little bit ago that you played, she feels like she's been freed because she's not going to be on any of these committees and that she plans to simply move forward doing the work outside of the committees. Of course, she's still allowed to vote, so she does get to represent her district in that way, Brooke.
Jessica Dean. With the smart questions, hold your ground. Jessica, thank you working that Capitol Hill beat for us. With me now to discuss all of this, CNN Chief Political Analyst Gloria Borger and CNN Political Commentator Charlie Dent. He is a former Republican congressman. So welcome to both of you. And my goodness, where to even begin on all this? Charlie, I'm starting with you. You know, you just heard Marjorie Taylor Greene. She says, you know, that she's feeling freed, not on these, you know, committees, that this is now Trump's party and only Trump's party. And based upon what Republicans did or didn't do, my question is it? I can't hear you, or you can't hear me, Congressman. All right, Gloria, question to you. What do you think? Is this Trump's party?
Yeah, at this point, I think the Republicans, at least in the House, are making a bet, of course, that it is Donald Trump's party. You saw that less than a dozen of them voted, you know, to take her off her committees. And I think the bet is that their voters, their base voters, 74 million of them, want Marjorie Taylor Greene to serve where she's serving. I think it's a deal with the devil. Because I think that Marjorie Taylor Greene showed very little, if any, remorse, refused to answer direct questions like those posed by Jessica. And I think in the end, this is going to be a big albatross hanging around their necks because she's not going to get docile. She is going to be more and more of a problem for them.
Yeah, I want to come back to that point because clearly she feels, I would say, emboldened. Congressman, I'm coming to you. Give me a thumbs up. You got me? Okay,
got you.
Cool. Let's talk about Ben Sasse before we come back to Marjorie Taylor Greene, because the Nebraska's Republican Party is now trying to censure their own Republican Senator Ben Sasse. A draft of the resolution lists more than a dozen alleged offenses against Sasse for, you know, going after former President Trump and even after Senator Josh Hawley. I want to play this clip and then we'll talk on the other side. This is what Senator Sasse had to say about all of this.
You are welcome to censure me again, but let's be clear about why this is happening. It's because I still believe, as you used to, that politics isn't about the weird worship of one dude. The party could purge Trump skeptics, but I'd like to convince you that not only is that civic cancer for the nation, it's just terrible for our party.
Charlie, what do you think of what he's saying, and what does this say also just about the Republican Party on the state level?
Yeah, many of these Republican state committees and local county committees have become very Trumpified. They've been taken over. It is alarming. And I see Pat Toomey was being censured by one of our county committees the other day. I was censured when I was in by a county committee. This is not uncommon. I should let you know, too, that, you know, right, as we're speaking, there's a summit going on among a number of Republicans that are talking about these very issues, people who feel so disaffected and disenfranchised right now by this cult of personality. The party has to return to something closer to, you know, a party based on values and ideals and principles, not the loyalty to one terribly flawed, disgraced individual. That's where we are.
Well, speaking of, well, I want to stay on your point about the, let's call it the Trumpification of members of Congress. Mm-hmm. I mean, Gloria, to your point about how Marjorie Taylor Greene, you know, feels totally emboldened. Mm-hmm. You know, she just said that if she was actually still on a committee, that she would be wasting her time. Do you think she's more trouble for Democrats and Republicans on or off her committees?
Look, I think she's, you know, she's got a big bullhorn right now, and she's tweeting away. This morning she said, I woke up early this morning literally laughing, thinking about what a bunch of morons the Democrats plus 11, meaning Republicans, are for giving someone like me free time. Well, she has so much free time, maybe she shouldn't be drawing a salary. I mean, if she doesn't have anything to do in service, maybe she shouldn't be, you know, taking money from the American taxpayer. So she feels emboldened. She says Donald Trump is in control of the party. And I think the congressman is absolutely right. Look at what's going on across the country right now. You saw Cindy McCain, Flake, and Governor Ducey censured in Arizona. And one of the reasons that Ben Sasse was censured, and I went through this ridiculous thing, was that he showed indifference to the factual evidence of illicit acts as were committed during the November 3rd election, meaning he didn't buy into the big lie, and that's why they're censuring him.
So it's a brewing, as we've been talking about, on the state level and now, you know, percolating among certain members of Congress, especially on the House side. Here's my overarching question. Charlie, this is for you. You know, the Republican Party has really now created this space, this safe space for the likes of Marjorie Taylor Greene. And, you know, we've been having these big overarching conversations about how did we get here as a Republican Party? We know how we got here. You know, Trump never denounced QAnon. He never denounced David Duke. He never said no to these people. He left the door open. Republicans left him. So, Congressman, unless something major changes, won't this now just keep the door wide open for more Marjorie Taylor Greens to be elected in the future?
Regrettably, yes. And when you think about it, I think the real sad legacy of the Trump administration was that the lowering of the standards bar. There used to be a time when, you know, we could get members of Congress to resign on their own, or there'd be forced resignations if they became a distraction or an embarrassment. That's not happening now. That should have happened. And I can think of 11 resignations since I was in Congress that were members actually resigned on their own or were forced because they became an embarrassment. In many cases, for issues smaller than what we're talking about with Marjorie Taylor Greene. And that's the tragedy right now. We've allowed ourselves to not enforce rigorous standards of these members. Marjorie Taylor Greene has no business being in the Republican conference or on any committees. You know, strong leadership would have said, you know what, we're going to primary you in 2022, and you know, you're not welcome in the conference. Enjoy your time here in Congress. That's how they should deal with her.